in genetics. In genetics, we are going to see Mendel's monohybrid cross. Explanation we are going to see. So what is monohybrid cross means? It is a cross between two parents who are differing in single trait or single character, we used to say. So what Mendel took for his cross is, he took height as a trait and he found two plants. One is tall and another one is dwarf. So it is a cross between two parents, which the parents are differing in a single trait. For the cross, Mendel took height as a trait and he crossed tall and dwarf plants. We know that already we studied, the characters are controlled by factors, which is later on identified as genes. Factors, now we refer these as gene or genes. So to refer these factors, for easy understanding, Mendel used corresponding English letter. So he gave capital T for tall plant and small t for dwarf plant. And these two are parents. These parents are always pure breeding. Pure breeding means, even after so many self-pollination, if it gives the same trait, it is said to be a pure breeding. So Mendel crossed a pure breeding tall with that of a pure breeding dwarf. We know that the factors always occur in pairs. So he has given another letter for easy understanding. So the parents are pure breeding. And they are homozygous. Homozygous means which is producing a single type of gamete, we used to say. So when he crossed a tall plant with that of dwarf plant, we have given TT and TT, small t and small t we have given. So when it is forming, this is their parent, which I already said, it is homozygous and it is pure breeding. So they produce a single type of gamete. So these two gametes unite to form a trait or an individual, which is, when we are seeing its external character, they are tall. But we know that characters are, half of the characters are produced from a male parent and half of the characters are brought from a female parent. So this is what Mendel said as first filial generation. So whenever we are seeing, or wherever we are seeing this first filial generation, they are heterozygous. Always all the F1 plants are heterozygous. So when the Mendel, what he did is, he self-pollinated the F1 plants. So the F1 plants produced two different types of gametes. So he self-pollinated, so we used to write two times, because for male and female, for male we have to write one time and female we have to write another time. So this T can go with this capital T. So capital T, capital T. Again this T can go with a small t, so capital T, small t. Now, the small t can go with capital T. So again, capital T, small t. Again, the small t can go with small t, small t, small t. So we are having four different types of individuals. So whenever we are having one single capital letter or single allele, dominant allele in a character, the dominant character will be established phenotypically. So we say this is tall. Again, we have one more capital letter. So this is tall, again tall. Again, here one more. So we have tall plant. So here two are small t, which is said to be a dwarf. So phenotypically, we are having three tall plants and one dwarf plants. Three set of, or 3% are tall, or 1% is a dwarf. So this is genotypically, when we are seeing its external characters, that is phenotype. When we are seeing a genotype, it is said to be, one is capital T, capital T, another two are capital T, small t, and another one is small t, small t. So when 1:2:1, so this is what Mendel performed monohybrid cross. So the ratio is said to be phenotypically 3:1 and genotypically 1:2:1. So to express this, when we are going for higher crosses and all, dihybrid and like that, if we go, we will be find it difficult to write all these things as it is. So Punnett, a man called, or a scientist called Punnett, devised a square to express the genotype and the phenotype in a square form, which we call it as a Punnett square. So in F1, if you see the monohybrid cross, we know that a male and a female, it produced two type of gametes. So just multiply it, capital T, capital T, capital T, small t, capital T, small t, small t, small t. So we have tall plant and we have dwarf plant. So this is what we call it as a Punnett square. So now in the monohybrid cross, you see who did it, what is the trait selected for monohybrid cross as given in the book, and what is a phenotype of a parent, and what is pure breeding, what is homozygous, what is F1 and what is F2, and the phenotypic ratio and genotypic ratio. So all these things you see, and we will be seeing dihybrid cross in my next video. Thank you.